Hi guys, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. So we have again started Morning Tales from now onwards so that we can make the best use of this time and know the current affairs at the best of our knowledge. So let's begin this video. But if you are a newcomer coming for the first time on this channel, then do not forget to hit subscribe to the channel and hit this bell notification. Also guys, you can join this Telegram group where you can directly connect with your mentors like me, Anutsa, Manish sir, and Pooja ma'am. There are many other mentors with which you can directly connect by joining this Telegram group. So the link of this Telegram group is in description below. If you want to join the group, you can click on that link and join this group. And this is the 2022 course, guys. In this course, you will get the 10 mock tests for each and every subject, like for phase one, for finance and management, for economics and social issues, for English descriptive. And for phase 3, that is your interview round, you will get assistance from our side. Also, in this 2022 course, you will get a book kit. In this book kit, you will have phase 1 question bank, phase 2 question bank, phase 2 revision booklet, phase 1 and 2 past years, starting from the year 2010 onwards, a notebook and a pen. If you want to avail this course, if you want to enroll in this course, you can avail a 30% discount, which is being run on this course right now. And in case you have any further queries, you can call us on this number, which is flashing on your screens right now. So on that note, let's start preparing for our upcoming examination. So the first question is, Border Roads Organization is celebrating the 60th anniversary of Project Dantak, which was launched in 1961 to develop roads and connectivity in Dash. So we have Nepal, Bhutan, Sri Lanka, Myanmar and Maldives in the options. Out of these, the right answer is option B, that is Bhutan. So in order to develop the roads and connectivity and leading the overall economic development in Bhutan, this project was launched by Border Roads Organization. Now this Border Roads Organization is responsible for developing the roads and connectivity in the border areas of India, as well as in the surrounding areas if the government of India permits, like it is developing in Bhutan. Now, as far as this Border Roads Organization is concerned, we should know one fact, that is the Director General of this organization, which was appointed recently in the month of December 2020. So who is the person who is chairing this Border Roads Organization? The Director General is Lieutenant General Rajiv Chaudhary. Guys, you can write this name, you can memorize this name. This is Rajiv Chaudhary. Lieutenant General Rajiv Chaudhary, who is the Director General of Border Roads Organization. As far as Bhutan is concerned, the Prime Minister of Bhutan is Lotte Shering. So these are two important personalities related to this question that can become the probable questions in your upcoming examination. Guys, I'm repeatedly saying upcoming examination because I'm not thinking of the examination getting cancelled. And you should also not think like that, okay? Examinations are not eternally postponed. They are temporarily postponed. Therefore, you should keep your guards up and keep preparing for your exams. No matter how much delayed they are, but they are still going to happen. So, do not let your guards down. Just prepare for the examination. Okay. Now, as far as this question is concerned, we have discussed everything. Now, I'm moving on to the next question. Mukti Jodha Scholarship Scheme aims to provide scholarship to the students of which country? We have Gambia, Bhutan, Albania, Bangladesh and Ghana in the options. Out of these, the right answer is option D, that is Bangladesh. Now this Mukti Jodha Scholarship Scheme aims to provide the scholarship of ₹20,000 takas and ₹50,000 takas. Basically 20,000 takas and 50,000 takas to these students of Bangladesh, and particularly the children of the army men of the people who have died fighting the 1971 liberation war of Bangladesh. So this is the specificity of this scheme, that is the children of the people who have died or who were martyred in the 1971 war will be given the scholarship by India, and the name of the scholarship is Mukti Jodha Scholarship Scheme. Now guys, this scholarship scheme is divided into two parts. First part is for the higher secondary school students, and those students will get ₹20,000 takas from the Indian government, and 50,000 takas will be given to the students of undergraduate, so who are pursuing their undergraduate. So these are the two parts of this scheme. Now, apart from this, you should also know this fact that the scheme was launched in the year 2017. So basically, this is the new version of the scheme that was launched in 2017, and this scheme aims to target a total of 2,000 students. So 2,000 students are being targeted by this Mukti Jodha Scholarship Scheme, which was launched in 2017. I said the new version of the scheme was launched in 2017. That means this scheme was originally launched before 2017. So in which year was it launched? The year is 2006. In 2006, this Mukti Jodha Scholarship Scheme was initially launched. In 2017, its new version was launched, and this new version aims to target 2,000 Bangladeshi students. And this scheme is divided into two parts. One part is 20,000 takas and second part is 50,000 takas. So that was all for this scheme and for this question. Now we are moving on to our third question, which is, which state has launched Ashirwad scheme? You have West Bengal, Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Punjab, Uttarakhand and Punjab in the options. Which one is the right answer? The right answer is option E, that is Punjab. So this Ashirwad scheme aims to provide the financial support of Rs 51,000 to the low income class families for the marriage of their daughter. Now guys, you should remember this thing that Ashirwad scheme was not launched recently. It has been in the news because the financial support given under this scheme has been increased by the Punjab government from 21,000 to 50,000 to 51,000 rupees. This is the breakthrough. This is the news for which this scheme has been in the news. 51,000 is the new financial assistance given to the families for the marriage of their daughters, and each and every family is eligible for two daughters only. Basically, two daughters of each and family, each and every family can avail the benefit of Ashirwad scheme. Now, you should also know this thing that this scheme targets only specific groups. One is economically weaker sections, scheduled caste, Muslim women, daughters of widows, and daughters of other backward castes. So basically, these are some of the castes that are being targeted through this Ashirwad scheme, that are being provided the financial support for the marriage of their daughter. And what is the eligibility for a family to become eligible for this, for getting the benefit under this Ashirwad scheme? The eligibility is ₹32,000 per annum. So this is the salary, this is the family income, that is the threshold for becoming eligible for this Ashirwad scheme. So I hope now you can understand all the aspects of the scheme, that is for the marriage of the daughters of low income class families in the state of Punjab. So that was all about this question. Now we are moving on to our next question. Which year will be celebrated as the Asia-India Friendship Year? 2023, 2022, 2021, 2024 or 2025? Which year is going to be celebrated as Asia-India Friendship Year? The right answer is option B, that is 2022. So recently, 23rd edition of Asia-India Senior Officials Meeting was recently held, and it was chaired by India and Thailand. So these are the two countries that chaired this 23rd Asia-India Senior Officials Meeting. And during that meeting, the officials, the participants discussed the ways to implement the Asia-India Plan of Action 2021 to 2025 better, as well as they discussed measures to strengthen the Asia-India strategic partnership. Apart from this, the most important declaration that was made during this meeting was the Asia-India Friendship Year, and the year is 2022. So that is something that is very important from this news, and you should remember that 2022 is going to be celebrated as the Asia-India Friendship Year. Now let's move on to the next question. How many countries are a part of the Net Zero Producers Alliance or Forum? So we have 5, 7, 10, 20, 50 in the options. How many countries are a part of Net Zero Producers Forum? So this forum consists of 5 members. Option A is the right answer. And which 5 countries are this? US, Canada, Saudi Arabia, Qatar and Norway. So these are the 5 countries, US, Canada, Saudi Arabia, Qatar and Norway, which are part of this Net Zero Producers Alliance or Forum. Now, this forum is for the oil and gas producers, and the main purpose of this forum is to implement the goals of Paris Agreement. So basically, this forum is targeting net zero emissions by 2050 by oil and gas producers. As far as this forum is concerned, this much is the news available to us till now. But in case this forum takes up an action, and is there anything that is related to this forum that comes up in the future, then I will cover that in the series only. But as far as the time is concerned, this forum is concerned, this much is the news available. Now we are moving on to the next question. Where did North Atlantic Treaty Organization conduct the joint military exercise named Defender Europe 21? So guys, this is a very interesting question as well as an important question also. This can become a probable question in your upcoming examination, which are expected to be held around July end. So you should better be prepared for your examinations like NABARD, RBI, SEBI. So these examinations can come up, and SBI clerk has already been announced. So there are chances that these kinds of questions can feature in your examination. So do listen to me very carefully. You have Bulgaria, Albania, Cyprus, Lithuania and Monaco in the options, out of which the right answer is option B again, it's Albania. So Albania, where is this Albania located? Let's have a look at it. So this red portion is Albania. Sorry for moving the picture. This portion is Albania. So between Serbia, Bulgaria and Greece, we have Albania, where this Defender Europe 21 exercise is taking place. Now guys, we have talked about this exercise, which is being conducted by NATO organization. NATO consists of 30 countries. Now these 30 countries consist of countries from European continent as well as from North American continent. These 30 countries are conducting this Defender Europe 21 exercise in Albania. Now, as far as NATO is concerned, you should know this fact that this organization is located in Brussels, Belgium. So it has its headquarters in Brussels, Belgium. And it consists of 30 members. It was formed in the year 1949 in Washington, D.C., USA, to have a defense alliance between the North American and the European countries to protect this entire zone of Atlantic Ocean as well as the countries surrounding that. Now guys, this organization is run by the Secretary General, and who is that person? This is your responsibility to find out. So find it out and mention in the comment section below. The next question is related to the banking sector. So which bank has launched Merchant Stack, a set of digital banking services for retail merchants? We have HDFC, ICICI, Indian Bank, Canara Bank and Bank of Baroda in the options, out of which the right answer is ICICI Bank. Option B again is the right answer. So this Merchant Stack is basically a suite of digital services for retail merchants so that they can offer better services to their consumers. And it has been launched in order to provide ease of doing business for retailers in the midst of this corona pandemic. So that is all for this question. You don't need to go into the detail of Merchant Stack, like what kind of services are being provided under it, because I don't think such kind of question can be asked in your examination. The most probable question that can be asked is which bank has launched Merchant Stack. So that is ICICI Bank, or the other way around this question can be framed with that this Merchant Stack is targeting which segment of consumers or which segment of merchants, like retailers, wholesalers, or you have the SMEs, entrepreneurs, startups. Which sector of business is this Merchant Stack application targeting? So that can be your other way around in which this question can be framed. Next question is, who has won the Order of Rising Sun Gold and Silver Race 2021? So you have Rajkumar Singh Thakur, Shyamala Ganesh, Kaptan Singh, R.K. Dhawan, Sanjana Pandey in the options, out of which option B again is the right answer. So option B is like the master key for you. If you don't know the answer, you can just bluff it like option B. So that was a joke, jokes apart. So it's Shyamala Ganesh who has been given this Order of the Rising Sun Gold and Silver Race Award. First of all, you should know this thing, that which country gives this award. So this is one of the highest civilian orders given by the government of Japan. And it is given to the people who contribute a lot towards spreading the culture of Japan in different regions, in different countries. This time, this award has been given to Shyamala Ganesh, which is who is a Bangalore-based teacher, and she has done a great job in spreading the Japanese language in Bangalore. That is why she has been given this Order of the Rising Sun, Gold and Silver Rays Award. So this is an important award. Guys, do remember this thing that it is given by the Japanese government. So that was all about this question. Now we are moving on towards the last slide of our video, and that is the thank you slide. Thank you so much, guys, for cooperating with me, for watching this video till the end. And if you have liked this video, then do not forget to like it, subscribe the channel and share this video. Thank you so much for watching the video.